Good day, I'm Mr. Manyamati. As another supervision of PP Mukonto and P. Ingwebe, I'm going to present about competition and modeling studies on scaling of bulk and surface of sperlite and copperite using Castep and OneTab. South Africa is one of the countries that are rich in platinum group elements, since it holds 75% of platinum and 35% of palladium. Platinum and palladium are the most prevalent PGEs, which constitute 21% arsenite and 19% sulfide, respectively. Sperlite and copperite are the most abundant platinum group minerals due to high demands of PGEs. In this study, the scaling of bulk and surface of sperlite and copperite will be investigated using CASTEP and OneTab codes. We carried out the study using density functional theory. We employed CASTEP and OneTab codes. For CASTEP, we utilized density functional theory dispersion correction using ultrasoft pseudopotential, and for OneTab, we utilized Vardafels using non-conserving pseudopotential. We used the cutoff energy of 450 electron volts and 500 electron volts for the bulk structures of sperlite and copperite, respectively. We then used a set of K points of 8x8x8 and 8x8x5 for bulk structures of sperlite and copperite, respectively, and a set of K points 3x3x1 were used for the surface of both sperlite and copperite. We then considered the use of aperture parameters and hydrostatic pressure. These tables display the effect of aperture parameters on structural and electronic properties of sperlite and copperite, respectively. For sperlite, as the aperture value is increased, the lattice parameter decreases with the band gap decreasing and closes at some point. For copperite, as the aperture value is increased, the lattice parameter decreases with the band gap increasing. We firstly optimize these bulk structures using CASTEP, since OneTab does not optimize lattice parameters. For sperlite, we didn't consider aperture parameters since they reduce lattice parameters and close band gap. For copperite, we considered the aperture value of 3 electron volts since we obtained good lattice parameters and band gap. These tables display the effect of pressure on structural and electronic properties of sperlite and copperite bulk structures. For sperlite, as the pressure is increased, the lattice parameter decreases with the band gap increasing. For copperite, as the pressure is increased, the lattice parameter decreases with the band gap increasing. We obtained good lattice parameters and band gap at the pressure of 2 gigapascals for sperlite system. For copperite system, we didn't consider hydrostatic pressure since we obtained good lattice parameters and band gap at the aperture value of 3 electron volts. These are structural aspects of sperlite and copperite, respectively, where on the far left we have a sperlite crystal structure that crystallizes in a cubic system, and on the far right we have a copperite crystal structure that crystallizes in a tetragonal system. Here we have unrelaxed and relaxed surfaces of sperlite and copperite using CASTEP and OneTab, together with the time it takes for each code to complete the geometry optimization of these surfaces. In conclusion, we were able to conclude that the use of aperture parameters and hydrostatic pressure produces good structural and electronic properties for most of crystal structures. And from previous slide, we were able to conclude that OneTab can be able to handle large surfaces with high level of accuracy with ease compared to CASTEP. I would like to thank the following parties. Thank you.